I first of all take this opportunity to thank the principal Savio, because he saw me, as he said, in the international school doing a demo, and he was very much impressed. So that time I think he should have taken that into his mind, and it was a wonderful moment when I met him as a principal in the school. I got an invitation when I went to matriculation school saying the principal of Vidyalaya wanted to see you. And when I came here, that was Mrs. Savio. And it was like, you know, I was so happy to see him, and he said, ma'am, surely we'll take this for our students in Velamal Vidyalaya with the consent of the teachers. Of course, you are the decision makers now. So I request you all to kindly be attentive, because it's going to be a wonderful session for you and very informative, interesting. If there are any queries, we have it at the last session. So anything you want to ask me, questions in between, so I'm going to show you Vedic Maths and everything. If you have anything in between also, we can share it. That's not a problem. If you don't understand anything, stop me then and there and we'll share it. Now, all my happiness going to share my knowledge with you. That's it. How I did this? Training the brain, right? So it's a whole brain development for children between 5 years and above. For 5 years and above, this is the course we are giving. And you might ask me, what is meant by whole brain development program? It is, you are going to stimulate both sides of the brain, the left side and the right side as well. So what happens when a child comes to school? You have 7 periods, 8 periods of lessons, right? How many periods you have?
8 periods.
So you have 8 periods. So you are taught, maybe it is a science period, math period, English period, right? You keep on studying all the periods. Maybe 1 period of games is there, and your school has a ECA, CCA periods. That's wonderful, which gives you a lot of extracurricular and co-curricular activities. And what happens when you come to school is your left side of the brain is activated, because the left side of the brain is for studies, logical thinking, mathematical thinking, etc. So most of the time we are activating the left brain only. What happens to the right brain in that case? What is for right brain? The right brain likes imagination, intuitive thinking, creativity. Do you have a period for imagination? Do your teacher allow you to imagine in the class? Does your teacher allow? No. What does she do if you turn your head in the class? Suppose the science class is going, you're turning your head like this. What does the teacher do? Look at me, or a chalk piece, chuck, right? Grab your attention. Because she's so concerned on you, thinking that you should be attentive in the class. Yes, she's very right. But what is happening with you children is the brain is shifting to the right, where the right will not allow you to listen to studies, right? So every 40 minutes there is a shift in the brain. Every child will do that. We need to understand as parents and teachers. The shift happens, that's why the child turns his head or being unattentive in the class. So we think that he is not listening to us, and we send a chalk piece to him saying that, now listen to me or look at me. Grab the attention of child at home, at school. So this brain shift, we stop there saying that don't use your right brain at all. What happens to the right brain? The right brain remains still now. So there's no activation for the right brain, because imagination is not there for the children. Even at home, we don't allow the children to imagine. As parents, can you tell me, do you allow your children to go sit in a corner for some time and make him imagine? Do we allow them? We just tell him, what are you doing? Do your homework now. After school, what he does, he goes to the tuition classes or he has to do the homework. Once again, the left brain is getting activated. So here, Brain Train has taken this into account, and we claim it to be a whole brain development program. We wanted to give the children a holistic development of brain, whereby the right brain is also given activation through 6 techniques. We call it a Super 6 Brain Pack. Through 6 techniques, we are going to activate the right brain. I'm going to show you a small demo of it. Okay, how this activates the right brain? and then how it helps the children to give their overall performance in everything, be it science, be it sports, whatever it is. He will be the best person. I'm here to I hope you all understand what a whole brain development program is, right? Not only activating the left brain, we are going to activate the right brain as well to help the children get good marks in their academics, show them powerful in anything they perform, right? Are you clear? See, yeah, this program is to activate both sides of your brain to help you perform good in everything, right? Now, I'm going to show you what are the six techniques which is going to help you. Let's start with the first technique, which is called magic fingers. So, what is magic fingers? Now, we all have fingers, right? So, I have to do some magic with the fingers now. Is it not? So, do you want to learn it? Magic? Yeah. Now, how many numbers you can show with your 10 fingers? Show me. Everybody, even the teacher that want to interact with me now, how many numbers you can show with your 10 fingers? Yeah, lift up your hands, teachers. I want the teachers to interact with me. So, we all can show 10 numbers with the 10 fingers prominently. I'm going to teach you 99 numbers with the 10 fingers now. Ready to learn? Ready to learn it? Yeah. Now, how do we do that? Now, first is your right hand, which is for units. Okay? So, if you close, this is 0. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is, everybody knows this is 4. And this is 5 in school. Right? If you ask a LKG child to show you 5, she shows this is 5. But here in brain train, the change comes in the 5. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. And the thumb alone takes the value of 5. Thumb alone takes the value of 5. 5 plus 1, 6, 5 plus 2, 7, 5 plus 3, 8, 5 plus 4, 9. So how many numbers I can show with my 5 fingers?
9.
9 numbers. What is this?
5.
5 and 1 is 6. Okay. What is this?
4. 2. 5.
This is 5. So this is 9. This is 5, right? Parents questioning to me, like, you know, don't the child gets confused? No. They are very clear in what they learn. Because being the competitive world, every child is so intelligent. They have to compete, so they learn it very properly. We have children from UKG and LKG doing this course, and they are very clear. Only the parents and the teachers get confused. Like, you know, if we teach like that, the child gets confused, is it not? No. I have shown you 9 numbers. I'm going to show you an addition subtraction with my 5 fingers now, because I have 9 numbers, is it not? 1 to 9 I can use with my 5 fingers, yes? I can add and subtract, is it not? Yeah. 2 plus 2 plus 5 minus 3 minus 1 plus 4 minus 6 minus 1 minus 1 plus 3 plus 5 minus 4. The answer is 5. I called around 15 numbers. There's no paper. There's no board. You don't need anything, just your fingers. Right? Shall I do it slowly? 2. Because you might think she's doing fastly, might be wrong. No. 2 plus 2. Right? Plus 5. Minus 3. Minus 1. Plus 4. Minus 6. Minus 1. Minus 1. Plus 3. Plus 5. Minus 1. Minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, plus 2, plus 2. You can just add up the numbers and get an answer. This is 9 now. I can just proceed. Minus 1, minus 1, minus 5, plus 7, minus 6, minus 2. The answer is 1. What happens in a child's brain? Now, why I'm going to relate this to the brain, right? I'm using my right hand to count the units and do an addition subtraction. Now moving on to the tens, then I'll tell you how this is related to the brain. Now I'm moving on to the tens with the left hand, right? Closing is 0, 10, 20, 30, 40. What is this?
50. 60,
70, 80, 90. 99. Very good. Very good. So when you open all your fingers now, that becomes 99, right? Thumbs up, both your thumbs up is 55, right?
Right, very good.
Very good, children. You are very good and very observative. Yeah? We are giving the answers immediately. Very good. Now see, now you can show 99 numbers with both your hands, add and subtract. I can do a two-digit addition subtraction now. Is it not?
Because I have tens and I have ones here. I can do a two-digit addition subtraction immediately. A child can do this. A child in LKG who does not know the numbers even start moving the fingers, start calculating. Yeah. Isn't it amazing? They can't even write numbers. They come into the class saying, my child can write only 1 to 10. There is no problem. We'll make them do it. Yeah. Now 21 plus 11 minus 10 minus 1 plus 20 plus 50 plus 5 minus 11 minus 20 minus 5. The answer is
30.
Huh?
60.
Right, so use both your hands and do some calculations. Now this is not a math program. I'm going to relate this to your brain. How this is related to the brain is, as human beings, we don't use the left side of the body at all, isn't it? Are we using the left side of the body? Can you give me an example for what you use the left side of the body? As you use the right side of the body?
Carrying water, carrying baby.
Yeah, you carry the baby. That's it.
Water.
Most of the time you use the right side of the body, right? To eat, to write, to give something. And even if somebody is going to give you something like this, you don't get it, right? Can I shake hands with Sarah at the left hand? What he will think of me? Why we are neglecting it? Now that is a question mark. Why do you neglect the left side of your body as you give importance to the right side of your body? And now what happens is your brain is cross-wired now. The right side of the body is controlled by the left brain again. That's why you are using your right side mostly. Because you are used to your left brain. And you are not using your right brain, that's why this is not coming faster. Right? So here what we are insisting to the children is use both your hands. Now when they are going to use the left hand, what they have to do? Automatically they have to do a coordination here with the mind, brain. Right side of the brain is used. Whereby they have to move the fingers here. When I say 10, this has to be related in the brain. Yeah, I have to move one finger. When I say plus 20, so there's a mind-hand coordination. So when you use both the hands, both sides of the brain is used, isn't it? So that becomes a whole brain development program. Whereby the child is supposed to use both sides of the brain. There is no measure or gauge to tell which side of the brain is activated, but here I can say when you use the left side of your body, your right brain is activated. So we usually in these classes advise the children to use their left hand as much they can use. Take something with your left hand, brush your teeth with your left hand. Not in the morning. You cannot brush your teeth in the morning, you don't do it properly. That when you come to the class, nobody will come here, right?
Only during nights, right? Just try using your left hand for something. Open the tap, right? Brush your teeth or do something which can be done with your left hand. Write with your left hand for some time. 5 minutes of your exercise can be with your left hand, which slowly activates your right brain. And this is called neurobics. What you are going to do is neurobics, like for the body we do aerobics, right, to keep you fit. We go to gym, we go for walking, we go for jogging. Why? You want to look smart, right? I want to keep me fit. But what happens to your brain? There is no exercise at all, which is very much important in your life. When you are a brainy person, what happens to you? You are welcomed by everyone, right? You are liked by everyone. If you don't have brains, if you are a dull person, anybody likes you? Nobody likes you. So brain is more important. Are we doing exercise for the brain, which is called brain gym? Do you see anywhere here in Chennai? Do you see any brain gyms? These are the brain gyms. These which is offering courses like this, or the brain gyms, which is very much important for everyone. You keep yourself fit in brain also, so that you behave properly, you project yourself properly. You can be a better person, right? I come to the point of why right brain should be activated. Right brain has so much powers in it. It is so powerful. How powerful it is, I'll tell you when I end this session. So that is what is magic fingers is. Are you clear? So we are trying to activate both sides of the brain with magic fingers. Now moving on to the next technique, which is Vedic Maths. Have you heard of Vedic Maths? Anyone here? What is Vedic Maths and where from it is originated? Yes? From our? Yes, from India, right? So that means it's from India. It's an Indian ancient mathematics. Right, as he told, you know, I did a research in Abacus. So I thought, why not our Indian thing should be added to the children, right? That is a Western thing where I studied Abacus. It was wonderful. I'll share that with you. But having come to India, I thought Vedic mathematics should be one part of the technique, right? So this is called 6-in-1 technique. So the next technique is Vedic Maths, where the Vedic Maths is, the owner of Vedic Maths is Indians. But it was stolen by the foreigners. You know that? The papers are all missing. And we don't know the author of Vedic Maths still. Somebody researched it. The papers were taken. It was manuscripts only. So it was taken by someone and it was written as a book. But most of the papers are missing. If you see Vedic Maths, the division part of Vedic Maths is missing. So the research is being done in Vedic Maths division part. So now Vedic Maths, why we call it as Vedic Maths is during the olden days, like they said. It is during the Vedic period, the Vedas. You know the Vedas, four Vedas? What are the four Vedas? Rig, Yajur, Sama, Atharvana. So from these four Vedas, this has been derived. So that's called Vedic Maths. Okay? And it is a one-line mathematics. It is a magic mathematics. It is a simple mathematics. And by looking at the problem, you can write the answer. Now, how this is related to the brain is, when a child does this Vedic Maths, new cells are formed. Because when he does Vedic Maths, he has to recognize the patterns in it. There is a pattern involved in each problem of Vedic mathematics, whereby when a child recognizes it, new brain cells are formed. That was the research says. So I'm going to show you a sample problem, right? Shall we? Yeah, I'll show you a sample problem. And the next problem is for you. So try to understand what I am writing here, right? Can you all see? 7254, right? Into 9999. I said it's a one-line mathematics where I don't need steps at all. Just by looking at the problem, you have to answer it. How much time do you need to solve this problem? How much time do you need to solve this problem? 10 minutes? 5 minutes? 3 minutes? 2 minutes? 1 minute? 5 minutes? Okay. Now I do that in 2 seconds. Right? Shall we? 7253274 6. Huh? Somebody is testing. Good. I need the time to write. Now this is the answer, right? So how do you get this? How do you get this? I know the pattern in this, but I don't know the answer is right or wrong. But I know the pattern is this, right? Shall we check it? Now, how many steps you have to write to solve this problem? 4. And then the last is the answer. Now, I have written it as one statement, right? Now, let's check. Now, this is a pattern where you are multiplying with a series of 9s. This can be applied only when you multiply with a series of 9s. You got it? Don't apply it to any other multiplication. Children, be careful. Now, when you multiply with a series of 9s, you can take away 1 from the first part of the problem. 7254 minus 1 is 7253, right? That is the first part of the answer. The second part of the answer is, you are going to deduct the 7, 2, 5, 3 from the series of 9s. 9 minus 7, 2, 9 minus 2, 7, 9 minus 5, 4, 9 minus 3, 6. That is the answer. The children has to write some steps and there are steps marks, right? Math teachers, are you here? Yes. So you are forced to see the steps and you have to give marks according to the steps. So we like only the conventional mathematics or the traditional mathematics. I don't know why we are not applying this in schools whereby the children are less burdened. I think the government is trying to bring this into the syllabus. Maybe it takes some more time because we as Vedic mathematicians are trying to push this. And is it not wonderful? Just look at the problem, write the answer. And you might ask me, if I cannot use this in school, why should I study this? Right? Is that your question? No? You like it? Yes. I give you an answer. You don't have to use this in school. You can apply this after you finish your max paper, test paper, exam paper. Check your answers by looking at the problem. Can you do that? Yes, you can check your answers whether it's right or wrong. If it is wrong, immediately go for the next corrections. So Vedic Max helps you correct your math paper. Number two, when you go out of your 10th, 12th examinations, after that you go sit for a screening examination where you are given only seconds to tick the answers in Max. Optional answers will be given and you have to tick it. You cannot go write the steps, do the problem, get the answer. Just by looking at the problem, you have to find out the answer. There will be 4-5 answers given, tick the answer. Who can do it? Only a child who undergoes Vedic mathematics training can only do this. Is it not? So now there is a competition between those who take Vedic Max, those who don't take Vedic Max. If you are going to sit for screening examinations, these kind of children will win. If you know Vedic Max, you will win. You will take very less time to tick the answers, right? So, shall we go for a sample problem for this? And you have to just read the answer sitting there. Tell me the answer sitting there, okay? It can be done with any numbers. No rough work. Just by looking at the problem you have to do. What rough work? Right? Can you take away 1 from the 7 and write the answer right? Right here. 5, 2, 9, 6. 7 minus 1 is? Yeah, that's it. 6, 6. Right. Now, what you have to do is deduct this from the series of 9. 9 minus 5. What's the answer? Right.
Yeah. Minus 4.
No. Just 4. After 6, 4. 9 minus 2? 9 minus
7,
2?
7.
9 minus 2?
7.
Right. 9 minus 9?
0.
Right. 9 minus 6?
3.
3, right?
3.
9 minus 6?
3.
Yeah, that's the answer. Very good. Thank you. What's your name?
Dhanapal.
Yeah, very good. Dhanapal. You got it? Are you all clear?
Yes.
So take away 1 from the first part of the problem, which is 52967 minus 1 is 52966. And then you are going to deduct this from the series of 9s. That's it, the second part. And you might ask me, this is applicable only for the, when you do it with a series of 9s, you have different patterns for different multiplications, different divisions. And for addition, subtraction, yes, we have 1001 patterns in Vedic Max and we need to apply. You need to learn all the patterns. That's where Vedic Max stands. You need to know all the 1001 patterns and once you know it, you will be the best in mathematics. Right? where you can attend any kind of examinations. You can compete with anyone. We move on to the third technique, which is called memory technique. Where is memory? Can you touch and show me the memory part of your body? Can you touch and show me where is your brain? Can you touch and show me where is your heart? Heart. On the left or the right? On your left. Can you touch and show me your brain? Where? Fine. What is the color of brain? Brown, no? You know what they said? Pink color. You cannot show them brain in red color. You cannot show them brain in blue color. See, they are telling green. It is a grayish matter. The shirt, gray shirt, yeah, maybe lighter gray. It is a grayish matter. It is not in any color. It's grayish matter, very light gray. Bring an apple to the class and show them this is apple. So that they see the color, they can feel the texture of an apple. Can they squeeze an apple? No. They know it's very hard. But when you give a tomato to a child's hand, they know the texture, you know. That's how you teach. That's called a kinesthetic way of teaching. Touch and feel and learn. There are three methods of teaching. One is kinesthetic. The next is visual. Third one is auditory. We have to follow these three steps in a class. We don't know what kind of a learner he is or she is. He might be an auditory learner. Fine. When whatever you speak, he hears and put it in the paper. Good. So they will be in the first 10 ranks. Whoever is auditory, they belong to the first 10 ranks. The next category goes to visual. Only when you show a visual of what you are talking, they can take it to the mind. The third category is kinesthetic. They want to touch it, feel it, and then they can reproduce it. So in a class, there should be three ways of teaching, helping them. Whatever you speak, put it in a chart. Draw it and show it to them. So this is what the teacher has to do or a parent has to do. I don't know what we are doing here. Maybe after this, we'll follow all these methods. Because Sarah is very much concerned about this program getting into the school. Maybe we will help you to do all this. Before that, we teachers will have a workshop or an awareness program for 1 or 2 days so that we implement this in every class. Okay? Now move on to memory. Memory is in brain. That's why we have taken the third technique as memory. And what is memory? What is memory? Yeah, storing and recording, registering. And then after that, you store it. After that, the next step? Remembering. You have to recall it. So the two R's of memory, R, is register and recall. Okay? So you register anything you see, you read, you look, you hear, anything you register. And when you try to recall, there comes a disturbance called forgetting. You forgot. You go into an examination hall, you look at the question paper, you realize I don't remember this question which I learnt last night. What happened to me? Now you wonder why I forget. Do you know why you forget? Why we tend to forget, not only children, we tend to forget as adults, you know, we also forget things. Why? Now I'll explain you why. Because the first reason will be, what can be the first reason for forgetting? Mugging up. Very good. Because you're all doing it. Mugging up. Two, no concentration. Three, I don't like it, right? I don't like my science teacher, so I don't get good marks in science. Yes, the teacher plays a major role in the subject liking. When the child likes you, he performs it very well. Because I don't like my math teacher, I'm not good in math when I was in my 12th. Right? So this happens. Three reasons to forget. One is you don't concentrate and learn. Second is you mug up. Third is I don't like it. No, I don't like it. I'm just giving you an example. Third is I don't like it. That's all. Right? So why you don't like it? There are various reasons. Right? I'll teach you how. Now what is memory, registering and recalling? Why we forget? Because of the three reasons. And what does memory like? Memory likes pictures, colors, moving objects, imagination. What does memory like? Pictures, colors, moving objects and imagination. You go for a movie, right? 3 hours we sit for a movie. When you come out of a movie, do you forget? Let's take Surya movie. You like Surya? Yeah, I too like Surya. You too like? You might be liking Tamana, right? No? Let's go for the boy's side, Tamana, and the lady's side, you know, Surya. Oh, you also like Surya only? Okay, fine. Perfect. I hope your teachers all like Tamana, is it, sir? Yes. Okay, now back. You like Shah Rukh Khan? Oh, I too like Shah. We all like Shah Rukh Khan as well, right? Yes, we all like Shah Rukh Khan. Thanks for telling this, because this is going to North. They may not know Surya, they know Shah Rukh Khan, right? Thanks. So, we all like Shah Rukh Khan. You go for a movie and look at it for 3 hours, come back home. Will you forget anything that has happened in a movie? Step by step, line by line, you will say, oh, Surya was looking so good in this that color dress and that song was so wonderful, you know. How do you recall all that? Because it has pictures, it has colors, it has moving objects and it has a story, right? That is what the memory likes. So how do we teach a lesson for a child? Apply all these and teach him. Memory likes pictures. So how do you convert a history lesson into a picture? Say there is a war. You are teaching a war between, First World War or Second World War. Still the lessons are not changed, I think, right? Still we are learning the First World War? Yes. So how do you teach that? So you just mono act. You can just call out the chronological dates for the children and when it happened, and they just see a realistic picture which is running there. So make it picturized for the children with the moving. They can move around and talk about, you know, you can give them something to talk on their subject. And it can be very lively instead of a teacher talking about that particular thing. If a child does a mono act of something, it gets into the mind because memory likes this only. So let us adapt these kind of methods into whatever we teach. It is possible. We are doing that. Okay? This is what memory is. And to test your memory today, there is a small test. Can we have it? Gentlemen at the back. Can we have a test? Yes? Ready. Now I'm going to tell you 10 words. Only 10 words. No, everybody is going to. Not only you, sir. Everybody is going. Thanks for getting up and giving and nodding of your head. Thank you. Now, I'm going to call 10 words. No writing. I can see somebody opening your books. No. You are going to just listen to me and then you are going to recall it, because we said the memory is for registering and recalling, right? So I'm going to call 10 words. Just recall it. Listen to me and recall it. Let's see how your memory works now. Shall we? Shall we, children, teachers? Yes. Now, ready? 1 pencil, 2 duck, 3 heart, 4 chair, 5 hook, 6 spoon, 7 flag, 8 cat, 9 fan, 10 bat. Now, no memory sharing, because it's like copying in an examination hall. Any one of you can just get up and call out the 10 words without jumbling. No jumbling. Who can call out the 10 words? Nobody? Yeah. Once more. No, once more. Are you allowed in the examination hall to go through the book once again and write the answer? No. So, no, once more. Let me say something. Now, you can share your memory. Copy editing. Now, can you all try together? One pencil. Very good, very good. Four chair. Five, six. Six spoon. Very good. Seven. Now, I'm happy that you are at least able to. Nine can. Thank you. Now, I'm going to show you a technique where every one of you is going to speak on this. Now, you have received the words and numbers with your left brain, right? Now, shall we shift to the right brain? I'm going to shift you to the right brain and show how powerful the right brain is. When you use your right brain also to coordinate with your lessons, you don't forget anything. Now, how do you shift to the right brain? I'm going to draw pictures because the right brain likes pictures, colors, imagination, intuitive thinking, creativity, everything is related to the right brain, okay? Now, and nobody is to help here, okay? Nobody has to help her. Yeah, come to the front. If you can come to the front, I'll be so happy. Please come to the front and face that side. Okay. Start.
One pencil, two dots, three hearts, four chairs, five hoops, six spoons, seven glass, eight cats, nine pans, ten bags.
If you would have seen her very carefully, she would have shifted her eyes this side and that side. I don't know what she did. She would have raised her eyebrows. You know, that means eyes shifted, no? That means she was left shifting from the left to the right. She called the number from the left, shifted it to the right to coordinate with the picture. This would have happened with her. It was tracked there. I can show you. Right? So, the left and the right brain now work for her together. This is what we expect from the children too. Is it not? Am I right? So you related the left and the right brain because when you call the numbers, it is from your left. When you call the pictures, it is from the right. So you coordinated, you are very much happy to talk out now. Previously, you are not like that. Thank you very much, ML Triya. I think that's your name. Okay, fine. Now that is what memory is. If you take anything into pictures, colors, imagination, that's going to work out very well. Hope you all are going to implement from the next class onwards, right? Or? Yes. Okay, now the next technique is, we are moving on to the thinking technique, the fourth technique. I have shown you magic fingers, Vedic maths, memory technique, thinking technique. Now thinking is a word related to the brain again, right? So we all think. How do we think is very sequentially we think. Normally we think, we all think on every aspect, but here we teach the children to think out of box, means lateral thinking, think differently, okay? We teach them how to think differently, not to think as others think, so that they stand out from others. That's what the course says. We want the children who undergoes this technique to stand out from others. So how do we do that? What do you mean by lateral thinking or out-of-box thinking? I'll show you an example. Now I'm going to draw a small picture. Tell me what it is. Tell me what it is. Very good. I like it. Yes, it is a hat. This is what the normal people says, right? Now as you have heard from me, you are going to think differently. You know, tell me, speak on this differently. A triangle and a square, then.
Rocket, straight line.
A rocket, yes. A pencil tip. Are you a math teacher?
No.
No? Why straight lines? Okay. I want, you have to name it. Name it. What? Crayons? Crayons, very good. Crayons, yes. Crackers. Yes? Post cover. Right? Post box. Pyramid. Yes, then.
Handbag.
Yes, then. Envelope, yes. You can say a lot of things now. Yeah? Letter, okay. Envelope. It's already told. Bucket. Yeah, very good.
What is that?
Bow and arrow. Yes, then. A kennel, a cage, an earring, a drops, a wall hanger. Anything you can speak. It is in your beholder's eyes. It is in the beholder's eyes how you look at it. Now this is what we do with the children for thinking technique. Right? We make them speak differently, think differently, and give them 20 minutes of time in every class to think, because as teachers and parents, we don't have time to give them to think. Even if they think and speak, you say, I don't have time to listen to you. Why are you wasting the time? It's only 40 minutes of science period. Why do you want to speak now? I have to finish my syllabus. Right? I have to finish my lessons. And we don't allow them to think or speak differently. So now here we are insisting, like, the children has to think differently and speak differently so that they stand out differently from others. This is what they need in this type of era. Like, they are facing a lot of competitions. I haven't faced any competitions in my life. That's why I'm standing here today. But this era children, they have to face a lot of competitions to thrive and come up, you know, survival of the fittest. So how are we going to help them? Let's think about it. Now, next technique is Win in 60 Seconds, which is a personality development course for children of this age. We are also touching not only the whole brain development, the whole mind, body and soul program, it is, I can call it as. So we are giving personality development for this kind of children, where we start by understanding yourself. The lesson, first lesson is understanding yourself. So first we understand ourselves to understand others. There starts the personality development. First you have to understand yourself. Have you ever taken time on a day to think about yourself? How many of you have taken few seconds today to think about you? Can you raise your hands honestly? And you're going to speak about it. What did you think about you? Yes, what? That doesn't come under, you know, about yourself, right? Whether I'm going to continue my job is your job.
Where I have to keep myself.
Okay. So, yeah. See, take time every day, few seconds, to think about yourself and what you're doing and which keeps you in the right track. Right? So, what we do in these lessons is, we make the children speak about them. Understanding yourself is nothing but you have to speak about yourself for 1 minute.
Hey everybody, today I am very happy to see you all. Because the same new case today, I learned more things today. Here, my name is Mrs. Maheshwari. Parameshwari. Sorry. I am checking myself. So we are vagabonds. We got whole bodies to train only for us. I think we are thinking everything. Today morning I thought of myself, tomorrow I will be with my family. I am thinking the happy moments when I am counting my minutes and hours, when I will reach home tomorrow. I have to finish all my work. When I talk to my elder daughter, I tell all Velamar stories to her. We will share our happy moments in Velamar. And she will be asking me in the morning, Mommy, when you will be back? Today evening you are coming? No, Mom, I didn't finish my work. Then tomorrow I will be late. So tomorrow, okay, mommy, you stay with me one day. We'll go there too. So.
Thank you very much. Okay, now, how you start about yourself is you talk about yourself, you say this is my family, and I understand she has an young daughter whom with whom she shares everything fine. So we all have to do that, and we all have a plus and minus. That's what I wanted to tell you. We make the children understand the strength and weakness through this lesson, understanding yourself. That's all 1 minute happening. In 1 minute, we can do a lot of things. That's what we stress to them, like, you know, 1 minute you can do a lot of things, why not study properly, right? That is what the within 60 seconds, and we move on to 1 minute praising, apologizing, accommodating, sharing, forgiving, all those words which is not in their dictionary nowadays, right? They don't know how to accommodate, they don't know how to share, they don't know how to forgive, they don't know how to say sorry to others, they don't know how to praise, because they are born as one. How many of you are one in your family? Only one. You don't have any siblings? No brothers? No sisters? How many of you have one in your family? One child. One child syndrome, I call it as. How many of you have one? Can you raise your hands? Two. That's very fine. Congratulations. I like it. When you have one child, what happens at home is there is nobody for her or him to share, accommodate, forgive. When you grow with others, like, you know, two, three siblings, where you need to understand, he's my own brother, sister. I need to share. I need to accommodate. I need to forgive. Right? All these will grow with them itself. But nowadays, we stop with one, and what happens is they become more adamant. They want what they want. That's it.
2050, there won't be cousins.
Yeah, there won't be cousins at all. He's very true. And why? Who's in charge of that? Why did we stop with one? Who asked you? That is not a child's problem, right? That is our problem. So don't ever blame the child like he's so adamant. He's so fuzzy. He's not accommodating. He's not sharing. He's not. It's all because of us. So let's take all the faults on us and treat them very properly and give them the lessons through this. Let them understand what is all about. You know, I have seen a lot of parents suffering from this kind of things where the children are not cooperating at home. That's why within 60 seconds came out. See, it's like, you know, I'm going to end up with the Abacus where I started my career. So Abacus, as he told, I went to China. The last technique is Abacus. And I went to China to do a research in Abacus. It's a wonderful tool where when you touch an Abacus, your right brain gets activated tremendously. Not slowly, not fastly. It is tremendously, it gets activated. And when a right brain gets powerful, you are a powerful person. You become a powerful person. The right brainers are more powerful. You go Google, surf in the net, you will see a lot of right brainers who are the toppers in their life. For example, all the scientists, Thomas Alva Edison, Albert Einstein, Da Vinci, everybody are right brains. Take Bill Gates, right? He's a right brainer. So all those who are in topper in life are right brainers. I don't mean to say left brainers are bad, but let us activate the right brain also. Right? So let's help the children to activate the right brain through these techniques. And you might have seen an abacus. Have you seen an abacus? Yes, it is a rectangular frame with the beads in it where you are about to move the beads and get the value. And at one point of time, we remove the abacus, real abacus from the children, and they have to imagine an abacus here and start moving on the air. Right? I'm going to show you a small problem now. There is an abacus before me. You also can imagine, start doing along with me either the conventional way of mathematics or try to write the problem and check the answer. Shall we? Ready? I'm going to do it here with my mind abacus. You're also going to try with the conventional maths or writing it in a piece of paper and checking the answer. Ready? There's an abacus before me. Can I? Start. 2, 2, 5 minus 4 minus 4 plus 9. Minus 10 plus 50 minus 49 plus 5 plus 3. The answer is 9. Yeah? Have you all written it? Computer? Missions? Big missions? You want anything here? Yes, we can just challenge. No missions can replace the human brain.
That's why they name the brain, and it is the right time, use it or lose it. Now we are going towards the missions where the children are focused towards the missions. We are not using the brains. Where let's help the children understand the powerfulness of the brain and give them the proper techniques to make it used properly. Hope you all like the program. And I once again thanks, sir, for giving me this opportunity to stand before you and deliver this. And he said, if my teachers like it, surely we are going to take it up. Hope you all liked it. Right? Yes or no? I want a big... Oh, I like the gents side now. They all lifted their hands. Yes, ma'am. Right? What happened to the ladies? Whatever. Yes. So, now your queries, if you have anything, you can ask me. This is a 6-level program for children for 18 months. Even the teachers can take the training from me, no problem, because that's what the Velammal matriculation is doing. Teachers are being trained by me in phases. And it is a 6-level program, 3 months each, 18 months program for the children, right? And we are doing it in 2 levels in a year. For the children, 2 levels, which is 6 months to 8 months, because more than that we cannot do. And for the school, if the number is volume is high, it is a slashed price we are giving. We are charging only for the books. So, hope you all understand what I spoke. And if you have any queries on anything, you can ask me now.
Ma'am, doctor, starting you told when we use brain pain, our brain cell will be gained, no, ma'am. But brain has property, when it loses the brain cell, it will not grow, no, ma'am.
No, who said?
Like?
Brain cells will not grow, wa. It grow until you die.
Particular age, then it will stop, no, ma'am.
No, not at all.
You have a wrong theory in your mind. As you use it, as I told you, no, you do exercise to keep you fit. Whenever you do exercises for your brain, the brain cells gets activated and you become very fresh. So it doesn't die. Any question? Thank you very much.